computer security is the protection of computer systems and their hardware, software, information and services from theft, damage, disruption and misdirection. So, enabling the firewall service. A firewall is a network security system that monitors and controls incoming and outgoing network traffic. A firewall typically enables a barrier between a trusted secure internal network and another outside network. That means firewall establishes a secure connection between the internal and external traffic. This is the internal internal and this is the external. Here, firewall acts as a barrier between the trusted secure internal network and another outside network. Firewall service, which provides a firewall in Red Hat Enterprise Linux, automatically enabled during installation. That means whenever we will install the operating system, firewall service automatically installed in a enable state. And the root user only can start and enable the firewall service. To display the current status of the firewall, we have to use the command systemctl status firewall lib. You can see in my server firewall service is active and in enabled mode. I have already told you what is enabled. Enabled means the service will be work across the reboot. That means whenever I will reboot the server, firewall service will automatically start. That is the meaning of the enabled step. So in my server firewall is active. Active step. If firewall is not enabled and running, then we have to use the command systemctl enable firewall dot service or systemctl enable minus minus now firewall. So this is the two commands using which we can enable the firewall service. But in my case, firewall service is in enable state. Now to check the open ports, we have to use the command firewall-cmd minus minus list-all. You can see there is no ports are allowed till now because this is the new system I have installed, so no ports are enabled now. To check the service, firewall cmd get hyphen hyphen services. That means using the get hyphen services we can see the allowed services, because I have told you we can allow either the port or the service. So what is the port and what is the service? If we talk about the service, that is httpd. This is the service name. And if we talk about the port, httpd service works on the port 80 or 443. So we can allow the httpd service or the 80 or 443 port. We can use anyone. To check the zones, we have to use the command firewall cmd hyphen hyphen get zones. You can see these are the default zones: block, bmz, drop, external, home, internal, public, trusted and work. These are the zones by default created in the system firewall. To open a port, firewall hyphen cmd minus minus zone is equal to public minus minus permanent minus minus r service is equal to httpd. So if we'll take the example of the httpd service, in my server you can see service httpd status. You can see httpd service in active or running mode. Another command also you can check. In previous classes I have told you systemctl status httpd or httpd dot service. Either one command we can use. Among the three command we can use any of the command. Whenever we will use the only httpd, it will treat as a HTTP dot service. Okay, so you can see HTTP service is running in my server. So what is the HTTP service? HTTP service is the web service. HTTP service is the web service. Web service means we can host the website using the HTTP service. So in my case, HTTP service is running. So now try to host an application. So now we will upload an application and try to host that application. This is the FileZilla tool. I have already told you, using the FileZilla tool, we can upload the file from my server to the from my desktop to the server. So you can see left side is the my desktop and right side is the server side. So from my desktop, I will upload a website template to the server. I have downloaded a template. This is the template, Ice Cream Shop website template. I will upload to var www html. This is the default path where all applications are using to host their website pages. So I have uploaded the web template to the web directory where HTTP service is using for the application. So now go to the /var www html. Now you can see, go to the also ice cream template here, mv star to var www html. You can see I have transferred all the contents of the website to the var www html. It will be better to show here. Now you can see I have transferred all the web application to the www html directory. So this is the default path of the website where we can host the applications. Applications means website. So now we will check if the website is working or not. How we will check? We have to only hit the IP of the server and check. You can see page is not opening. It is only trying to connect to the server. So how will check the if the port is open or not from my desktop to the server? We can use the telnet command. Please remember telnet, then server IP 192.168.37.135, then port 80. You can see telnet is not working. That means server's firewall service is blocking the 80 port connection from my desktop to the server. That's why website is not running and telnet is also not happening. So what we will do, we will know now disable the firewall service. We will stop the firewall service and test if the website is running or not. Service stop firewall. Now check the status. You can see now firewall is inactive and dead state. So again try to browse the application. You can see website is running. That means we will now confirm here. You can see telnet is also happening. That means only the firewall service is blocking the 80 port connection from my desktop to the server. So how we will manage the firewall? Now we will enable the firewall service. We will enable the firewall service and we will open the 80 port. To open the 80 port, command will be firewall hyphen cmd minus minus zone public minus minus permanent minus minus r service http or port tcp 880 tcp. We can use any of the command. Now you can see port is allowed. HTTP service is allowed. So now we have to reload the firewall service. To confirm if the port is allowed or not, we can use, you can see here HTTP service is allowed. Okay, now check if the website is browsing or not. You can see website is browsing perfectly. That means this is the way to allow the required ports or services through the firewall. You can see status of the firewall is in active state. So we have allowed the HTTP service through the firewall and now my website is running. So this is the way to allow the ports or services through the firewall. Is it clear to you?
Yes, sir.
Now SE Linux. SE Linux is the another security tool available in Linux operating system. In SE Linux, there are two states. One is disabled state and another is enabled state. Likewise, firewall, two states are there. One is disabled state, another is enabled state. Whenever the SE Linux is enabled state, there are two states. Another is enforcing and another is permissive. etc SE Linux and config. This is the configuration file. If you will open that configuration file, you can see here there are two modes. One is disabled mode and another is enabled mode. In case of enable, there are two modes again. One is enforcing mode and another is the permissive mode. Whenever the SE Linux is enforcing mode, SE Linux security policies enforced. And in case of permissive mode, SE Linux prints warning instead of enforcing. That means SE Linux will allow the activity, but the entire activity will be logged in the log file. Can see whenever the state is enforcing mode, it enforcing mode SE Linux enforce the loader policy, and enforcing mode is the safest Linux mode and is the default mode after installation. Whenever you will install a package, after installation SE Linux mode will be enforcing mode, and in case of permissive mode SE Linux does not enforce the loader policies. And SE Linux does not deny access but reports action that break the rules. And log file location will be var log auditor log. Permissive mode is the default mode during the installation. Whenever we will install any service of that type, AC Linux will act as a permissive mode. Once the service is installed, after the installation, it will be in enforcing mode. So how we will check the AC Linux status? We will check the status using the command AC status. Command will be AC status. Now you can see AC Linux status is in enabled mode. So if you want to stop the service or disable the service, we can use the command set enforce 0. That means, or set enforce permissive. And to enable the service, we can use the set enforce enforcing and set enforce 1. And please remember, this is the temporary set AC Linux status. If you want to make it permanent, we have to change the status in the configuration file. We have to use the configuration file etc AC Linux slash config. Here we have to modify it. What we'll do in AC Linux, here you can see it is in enforcing mode. We will do it the disable step, disabled. We have to modify here and save the configuration file. But please remember, after save the configuration file, we need to reboot the server. Without reboot the server, this configuration file configuration will not work. Once modified here, we have to reboot the server. So is it clear?
Yes, sir.
So this is the security module available in the Linux operating system. One is firewall and another is the AC Linux. So if you have any query, please ask me.
So default is enforcing mode, sir.
Default is the enforcing mode.
Okay.
You can see previously here AC Linux was in enforcing mode. Now I have modified to disable state. If I will reboot the server, after that AC Linux will be in disable state. Every time we modify the configuration, it's required a reboot.